Welcome back, everybody, to the morning show. There is some fog out there, a few delays at the bottom of your screen. Keep that in mind. 6:41 is the time. Well, this weekend, it is that weekend, you could experience the rhythm of African drumming and help out a great cause at the same time. Here to talk more about Drumming for Hope is Rebecca Konjorski, the founder of African Youth Outreach. And I think this is the second or third time we've had you on the show for this event specifically. And it's grown by leaps and bounds, too, right?
Yes, we're very excited. It's the fifth anniversary, the fifth annual Drumming for Hope, so our nonprofit has been an official 501c3 5 years this March.
Okay.
So we're very proud of how far we've come, but we're only just beginning to figure out where we can go and what we can do, so it's very exciting.
So who do you help, African Youth Outreach?
We do HIV prevention and life skills training in Wisconsin and South Africa.
Okay.
The past 5 years, we've focused a lot of our efforts in South Africa, working with AIDS orphans and doing HIV prevention, rape prevention, and life skills training. But we are actually staying in Wisconsin the next 2 years to focus local and increase access to HIV prevention here.
And in the meantime, you're having this event where you can listen to great music, bring your kids, have a good time, and hello, shop. We need to talk about some of the items that are, you know, for purchase when we're there.
It's good. We're having a huge sale. We're doing some spring cleaning. So come ready to shop. We're clearing out our inventory because we're trying to raise money to build a borehole in South Africa for some clean drinking water.
And while we're looking at those photos, if we can pan right there, stop if you don't mind, whoever that is. Thank you so much, Caleb. Great job. Look at those pictures, how gorgeous they are. And explain what those are from South Africa,
yes.
Right?
My husband and I take the photos when we travel to South Africa as a way of raising funds for the nonprofit. And also showing the beauty of South Africa, both the people and the animals. And we also like connecting the importance of conservation of animals and HIV, that they're both connected.
And looking at the picture on your left, if you're one of Christine's loved ones, you can purchase that for her for the next holiday. She's over there nodding, nodding. And now I also wanted to show this T-shirt, if possible, because there are a handful of these. This is a size 24 months, which is about right. My 2-year-old son would love this. He loves giraffes. And check it out. The giraffe walked on this first. And there's a monkey and a puppy. You also have these fabulous, fabulous dolls.
Those are all,
how these are made?
Those are all, the wool is hand spun and they're all hand knit and signed by the artist. They're made for a group called the Kenyatta Knitter Critters Kenya. And they're just beautiful and they're so original.
All right. Well, before we run out of time, again, there's great shopping and great music there, of course. This is for African Youth Outreach. Drumming for Hope is Sunday.
Yes.
What is the time again?
It's from 3 to 7, mm-hmm. And we have added a health fair aspect as well. So we have HIV testing, blood pressure screening, and we're screening a 20-minute video on HIV about 3 times through the event with Q&A time, so you can take a break and check out your knowledge. And there's a live penguin, too, so come see Kelvin from the zoo, black-footed African penguin, because most people don't know they live in Africa, so it's a good educational thing about that as well.
I just learned something.
Yes.
There you go. Rebecca Konjorski, thank you so much, and I hope to be there on Sunday,
yes,
too.
Yes, we hope to see you. Thank you. Come after the parade.
Yeah, exactly. This is a good idea. All right, over to you guys at the desk. I'll tell you, after spending...